Hello, today we'll look at diabetes mellitus and the symptoms of it. We know that in diabetes mellitus we have a lot of sugar in the blood. So we call it hyperglycemia. Glycemia, it's meaning glucose in the blood. Hyper is a lot of. So we have high level of glucose in the blood, and then this reaches the kidneys, and the kidneys, as we know, secretes stuff and absorbs stuff. And what stuff do we talk about today? We're talking about glucose. So glucose comes in the blood. Now the kidney absorbs glucose up to a certain threshold, and this is up to 180 milligram per deciliter of glucose, or one can say in another measurement called millimole per liter, that would be up to, so, or more than 10 millimole per liter is then the threshold. So this means everything above 180 milligram per deciliter or above 10 millimole per liter is not absorbed. Up till then it's absorbed, and above that it is excreted, because the capacity of the kidneys cannot absorb more glucose. And now we have a patient, let's say he has 200 milligram per deciliter of sugar in his blood. What happens? We will absorb 180, and the rest 20 cannot be absorbed by the kidneys because the kidneys function is having a limit. The 20 milligram per deciliter of glucose will now be excreted through the kidneys, and then we call it what? Glucosuria. We have glucose in the urine. We have 20 milligram per deciliter of glucose in the urine. What happens then? If we have a lot of glucose in the urine, as we know, the concentration of anything like blood or urine, if that is increased, as we have in this case, we have a lot of sugar in the urine, then what tends to happen is that water comes and tries to dilute it, because the body hates when the concentration is too high in one side and too low in the other side. And we have two sides here. We have one side being the urine and one side being the cell, the kidney cells, for example. So what happens is that water will be moving into the urine. So we have something called osmotic diuresis. Osmotic diuresis, osmosis, is something that is related to the concentration of one side and the water moving always toward the more concentrated side. So, and this logically, what will happen is that the patient will urinate a lot, because we increase the water flow into the urine, which means that the patient feels that he needs to go and urinate a lot. And we call it polyuria. Poly means a lot, urea means urine. So we have polyuria. How did you come there? Once again, we have hyperglycemia, high level of glucose in the blood. The threshold of the kidneys had up to 180 milligram per deciliter, or up to 10 millimole per liter. We reached that, and was overproducing with 200 here. The rest, this 20, got into the urine. We had a lot of concentration of glucose in the urine. Now the water tries to dilute it, so the patient feels that now he needs to urinate a lot, so he has polyuria. So we have some terminology here: hyperglycemia, glucosuria, glucose in the urine, then polyuria. This was the sequence. What happens if you have polyuria now? You excrete a lot of fluid. As we said, a lot of water is going there. You excrete glucose also, but you excrete a lot of fluid. What happens is that you get dehydration, hypovolemia. Hypo means low, vol means volume, emia in the blood. So you have a low volume of blood now, because you excreted a lot of water. As we know, blood consists of water mostly. So if we excrete a lot of water in the urine, then the blood will drop in your body. So your blood pressure will also drop. What happens now? We have terminology: hyperglycemia once again, glucosuria, polyuria, and due to polyuria, we then get dehydration, hypovolemia. When we have a lot of, when we have low level of blood, that will also lead then to the brain saying, please do something. I have low amount of water in my body, or blood in my body, please do something. What do the brain do? Then it says, please drink something or eat something. And now comes the two more terminologies here: polyphagia, polydipsia. Poly meaning a lot, dipsia meaning thirst, a lot of thirst, so drinking water. Or polyphagia, a lot of phagia meaning eating, a lot of eating. And this is pretty much it. This is the most common symptoms of diabetes mellitus. Then above that, we have also something which is blurred vision. We can have, for example, weight loss, but usually in diabetes 2 patients, we usually have an obese patient. In diabetes type 1, we have then usually a lean body weight. But we can see in some patients weight loss and blurred vision, because we know diabetes mellitus affects the retina in the eye and you can get the blurred vision. So the symptoms was we had hyperglycemia, when we have glucosuria, so a high amount of glucose in the urine. Due to that high amount, we now have high concentration, the water flows there. So we will now have polyuria, so a lot of urine that the patient excrete. Due to that, we will have a low level of blood, so hypovolemia. And due to that, we need to drink a lot and eat a lot, and therefore we have polydipsia and polyphagia. So to remember the symptoms themselves, just the names of it, because glucosuria is not the symptom. Hyperglycemia is not the symptom. I just explained the sequence. The symptoms would be what? Polyuria, meaning a lot of urination, polydipsia, a lot of drinking, and polyphagia, a lot of eating. And then above that, we have blurred vision and weight loss in some cases. So this is the main symptoms that you need to remember. And there are, of course, many other symptoms that we can discuss. For example, foot ulcers, for example, paresthesias in the legs, meaning that the sensitivity of your skin is getting worse. But these are the late complications of diabetes mellitus. And as we said, diabetes mellitus is a disease that is mostly asymptomatic, meaning there's no symptoms. In type 2 diabetes, usually we don't have any symptoms. In type 1, we usually have symptoms. In type 2 diabetes mellitus, we are talking about obese patients who are a bit older. In type 1, usually they are younger and usually they have symptoms. So most of the patients that you will meet who has diabetes mellitus do not have any symptoms. In order to know that we have diabetes mellitus, we usually do a blood test, and there we see that the sugar level is high. So it's just a coincidence. The doctor will see the lab results, and then we go on and diagnose diabetes mellitus based on some values of sugar in the blood. So hyperglycemia, as we said. But if you want to know the symptoms, which are very rare, as we said nowadays, because as we know, we want to prevent diabetes mellitus, and therefore we usually test patients very early on. So usually we will find out that if a patient has diabetes mellitus before he has any type of symptoms. But the symptoms, as we said, polyuria, polydipsia, polyphagia. Remember the P's, three P's. And the sequence was polyuria, then polydipsia, and polyphagia. And as we know, once again, the sequence was hyperglycemia, high level of glucose in the blood. The kidney cannot absorb more than 180 milligram per deciliter or more than 10 millimole per liter. Therefore, the rest will be excreted in the urine. Now we have high concentration of glucose in the urine. Therefore, the water tries to dilute it, so we don't have it. Therefore, we have dehydration, so hypovolemia. We will lose a lot of water, meaning we will lose blood pressure. We will lose blood. The brain will activate and will tell us to please drink and please eat something. That's it. Thank you very much for listening. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.